So if you've got daily habits that are, so don't take it as a negative word, that are not good for your business, that are bad, you might have a good vision, but the habits are not going to help you achieve that vision. And therefore, you will tend to miss on targets, goals, and the vision. However, if you change the overall picture, you have good habits, you ensure that whatever unfolds in front of you is going to help you achieve your vision. Two key questions to ask you. Do all of us have the right habits, and have we written a vision for our own selves in the next 36 months? If we've got these two things right, we've made the first two steps towards achieving our goals. And if we don't have something, the question to ask yourselves is why? Is there something harmful in getting a goal in front of us for the next 36 months? And then looking at the kind of habits that we currently have to achieve those goals? So that's the question that I'd like to leave you with for now. How does all of this apply to an entrepreneur like us? With a clear vision of what you want to achieve, lack of resources, which we always find as reasons for us not to achieve our targets, are the lack of resources. Lack of people, someone said, is not helping me achieve my goals. Is that a real reason? I'm not too sure. Lack of a good market, lack of, you know, regulator support, lack of the whole funds performance, whatever it is, are all reasons. The true reason is to be able to have a vision and then back it up with the right habits. Then lack of resources will never impact you. I'll give you an example for this. This individual had the vision of a cafe. Let's look at his case. A young man whose family owned a few coffee plantations had a vision to set up a chain of cafes across the country where youngsters would drink coffee, hang out, and listen to music. Now that was his vision. At that time when he had this vision, coffee estates were facing a serious market recession, and this is reality. Most of the plantation owners were frantically selling their estates and were getting out of business. So when people are getting out of business, when the overall environment for business is negative, this guy had a vision. He wanted to swim against the current, and what happened? At the same time, people were reducing coffee consumption at that point in time. Financial advisors were against any exposure in this industry. Everything was seeming to go against the vision that he had. And look at the power of his vision. He could have chosen the first option, defer your dream, sell off your plantation, and live a comfortable life. Don't take the risk that your vision is asking you to take. But he did the other way. Siddhartha stuck to his vision today, and he purchased thousands of acres of plantations at a time when people were getting out of business, when the overall sentiment of that business was negative. And today he owns a successful cafe, thousands and hundreds of thousands of them across the country. So what happened is, lack of resources was never demotivating an individual who was driven by vision and who was set on achieving his vision. So vision also makes you see opportunities when others see diversity in the way Siddhartha saw it. So think about it. We have another example, Bangalore-based. I've picked up both Bangalore-based examples. VSS Money, he had a vision to start up a business that provides any kind of information to public 24/7 on the phone. He did not have enough money to fuel the vision that he had to achieve the goal. At that time, getting a phone connection also took many months. He knew that his business needed a lot of phone lines to come alive. So what did he do? He could have easily chose the first option and said, you know what, things are not helping me, so let me take a back seat. But he changed course. He set up a matrimonial magazine, raised money for his vision. When the magazine became successful, he sold it off and used the money to set up a business to sell information on the phone, and that's how Just Dial was born. So people who've demonstrated a strong resilience towards a vision that they've set for themselves, 10x becomes a small number. 36 months becomes too long. It just depends on the determination of your vision, but first it's necessary to first have a vision and then back it with passion. Just Dial creates over 100 million unique users, and we've got its presence over 240 plus cities. Now that's the power of a vision, even in a seemingly negative environment. So when you have a vision, a dead end seems to be a sign to take a diversion. It's not a dead end, it's the bend in the road. So it also helps us overcome complacencies and reach new heights. So vision, we've just covered all of this. The four most important benefits of having a vision is that you're on course because of these four that we've got. So setting up your vision becomes important. 3 years from now, 36 months from now, as professionals, how big will my business be in terms of volume and reach? If you're able to find your answer, deliberate on it, put it down before you leave the 7th convention of Kamfa today evening, I think we've begun a journey. On a personal footprint, what would I have achieved in my personal life? Because I think both are seemingly very integrated. And then financially, how much money would you like to earn per month or at the end of 36 months? How would you want to quantify it? Building this and putting it on a vision board will, because the emotions you carry today when you set your vision and your goals, that emotion will seem to be continuously fading if you don't have a vision board. So put a vision board in your office, at your house, and put it pictorially. Put it pictorially like this. Buying a house in Goa, my vacation in Paris, take my business to the next level, have my own office space if you don't have one already. What could be things that are emotional? Do not represent numbers here. It's emotion. It's a picture, you know, that you're dreaming of. That's not money here, it's emotion. So vision without action is merely a dream. Action without vision possibly is time pass. Only when you have vision backed with the right action, you will see your world changing, you will see transformation, you will see 10x, and 36 months might be too long for it. But having a vision, having the right habits, is that enough? No, we just said vision with action is important. So the action is about a formula which is CDSE, consistent action, directed action, well-directed, and self-motivated action will ensure that nothing comes in the way between us and 10x. Consistent action. Think about it. We want to dig a borewell. We go 80 feet here, we don't find water. We go to that end of the room, we dig 100 feet there, we don't find water. Go to this end, dig 120 feet here, we don't find water. Is the problem that water is not available, or is the problem that I didn't dig deep enough in one place? Had I accumulated all of this and dug 300 feet here, I possibly would have got water. The problem is in my inconsistency. So if I bring in consistent efforts, I direct them well. Why is direction important? It's good to walk slowly in the right direction than run in the wrong direction. So let's walk slowly, it doesn't matter, we'll build momentum, but let our direction be right, let it be driven by the right habits. And then of course, self-motivated, we are not looking for motivation from outside if our vision board is motivating us enough. To summarize, we grow our mutual fund consulting business in 36 months by 10x, by setting a vision to realize our true potential. And all of us know that our true potential is there, our performance is here, we can bridge the gap. Setting a vision is the first step. Changing daily habits, because when you have a vision, you know whether your habits are in alignment with achieving this vision or goal. If they are not, change your habits will change your future. And CDSE, consistent, directed, self-motivated efforts is what is gonna make this foolproof. To top it up, this is strategic. I'm going to give you three tactical tips because I'm a sales trainer. This comes from the sales training side of me. So the right sales approach is needed, you know, when you're attracting clients, because yours is a trust business. You got to build trust, rapport, relationship, trust. You become referable, and therefore hunting versus farming. Sometimes we are tempted to go out there in the market and hunt people down so that we are able to achieve our revenue targets, our sales numbers, all of this. But then that's going to be short-lived. Today it's about earning trust. We need to go behind the farming approach. So that's the first tip. Second is work on quantity rather than just one of them. In the aspiration and drive towards achieving more client acquisitions and going behind quantity, we somehow miss the key account clients. We somehow miss the quality in the approach and the quality in our positioning. And sometimes when we go behind a few, we have a small sales funnel. We go behind quality, we go behind key account management and acquisition, we miss the numbers. So I think the future is about quantity. Balancing quantity with quality. Balancing the law of large numbers with the kind of revenue. So somewhere you will get higher revenue, somewhere you will get bigger clients. And that small client today is going to grow with you if you've adopted the farming approach. He's small today, he's giving you a small SIP, but tomorrow he can become really big. If you've adopted the farming approach and not the hunting approach. So catch people small, watch them grow, don't miss the quantity in aspiring for quality, don't miss the quality in aspiring quantity. Both are necessary for a business to sustainably exist and continue growing. The last one is the 4C. I think the whole convention is designed keeping this in mind. I really liked it, so I'm concluding with the 4Cs. Continue to communicate, because through communication, learning will start, and learning will contribute to earning. So communication is the fundamental lifeline of a business. Through communication, we need to collaborate. And collaboration and networking is so important. I'll leave you with one important adage about networking. Today's net worth is getting defined by your network. Your network is defining your net worth. If you want your net worth to grow by 10 times, you really don't need to work too hard. Make your network work for you. You work on your network, the network works for you, your network defines your net worth, and you grow, you continue to grow. And that's how you capitalize on networks and build competency, continue to sharpen your axe, and you'll be productive out there in the forest, cutting down more trees, and that's how we can continue to be productive. Thank you so much for this opportunity. I enjoyed myself on the stage, and I hope you all found value in the last 45 minutes. Thank you to Kamfa, thank you to the organizers, and I'm sure this convention, which is the 7th today, will continue to add value in the subsequent years. Halls will become bigger, people will enter this field, and you all will set the precedence of people achieving 10x in 36 months. So all the best, God bless.